Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. I have the questions from the YouTube subscriber Isaac asking about the technique how to do this braiding design here and rope looking design over here. So today we are going to go over with this technique. Are you ready? Let's get started. There are three parts in this ring. First is the ring itself. The second one is the rope looking design over there. The third one is the braided design over here. So we are going to talk about those three parts separately. Let's start with the ring. We're going to use the circle, set it up the radius for 8 or diameter for 16. And then we're gonna come into the right view. Want to draw a profile here. I always like the cushion looking thing, so let's use the conic corner. And then you can do any size of the ring that you like. It's gonna be really wide over here, and we're gonna moving in a little bit, so it giving a little bit more like a comfort fit. Then let's move the center back to the center over here. The second, we need to decide how deep it's going to cut it into. Let's draw a rectangle here with the center, and this is going to showing like how deep you are going to cut into it. And again, there's no specific dimension. It's just about your design. Then we are going to use a trim tool to trim off anything in between. Make sure you give a little bit fillet here so the ring rendering will look very nice. Where on the bottom, you don't have to worry about it. Okay, so this is the curve that we have that's joined it, and that's making a ring by using the sweep one. And this is the rail, this is the cross section, then we get a ring like this. Let's take a look on the perspective. Now we have this on the perspective, and we only need to use the one to flow is the surface right there in the center. So let me extract the surface, and we're gonna extract the one over here. Let me turn it into the red color. So we have something here to create a UV curve. The command we're gonna use, create UV curve, and then we pick up this red one. And this is the area we are going to design. So let's take a look on the top view. This is the area we are going to design, and we need to separate them into three sections. So I kind of need to know how big they are first. So let's say we have 5.94 millimeter. Let's say I'm going to have the area in the center for 3.5 millimeter by 3.5 millimeter. And this is the area for the braided design. So I'm going to align this with the horizontal center. And the rest of the space is for the rope looking design. So let's come over here. Let's do the rope first. All right, to make our rope look really nice, we need to know the dimension over here. This one is 1.22. So I like to create a rectangle here. This is 1.22 by 1.22. All right, so we are going to work within here. Let's go ahead to draw a diagonal line right here. And so half of a rope should fit it into right here. We are going to draw a reference here, roughly about 0.4 millimeter. And I want to snapping into this edge here, and doing the same 0.4 millimeter and snapping right here. What I do here is because we need to have a two symmetrical side. So let's go ahead to use that as our first point. And you kind of want to draw a curve of your own design, but you will need to snapping in those two ends. And you can edit those to fit your design better, but pretty much this is the first curve. And then we will have this one, and using the rotate tool, snapping into this midpoint, and we want to rotate it 180 degrees. Then they will snapping into right point. They should snapping into right point. Let's double check. Oh, it's not there. Just need to make sure they move it back to the end point, so you won't have the problem when you try to create in the surface. This one does meet. All right, so then we will need to create the cross section. I'm going to have the oval or ellipse tool, and I want to do something like this. And coming over to the right view, And we don't need it super high. We probably need it just less than 0.5 millimeter. So roughly like that. So half of this oval is less than 0.5 millimeter for the thickness. Let's use the command called sweep to rail. This is rail 1, rail 2. Make sure you want to start in with the point and then go into the cross section and end up with the point one more time, and then you will get a solid. Let's double make sure this is a closed surface. Now we have one element right here. Let's do a test and see how it goes. Let's make a duplication of this one. We are going to use the linear array, and I don't know how many of them that I need. I'm just gonna guessing 100. And we're gonna go from here to anywhere, but make sure you stay with the line so they will be aligned perfectly. Okay, you can get it tighter, you can get it looser, it's up to your design. Okay, so I'm gonna get something similar like this. And take a look if this is enough for you, and it's more than enough, so I'm just gonna delete some of them right there. We are going to float this back to the surface, right? So if you have an empty space right here, then you probably won't float correctly. So what I like to do first is I actually want to bowling all the foam. That's using the bowling union. Okay, so once they are bowling, I'm going to move with this as my guideline and move it to the edge right there. Okay, so you're gonna notice like everything will moving a little bit. If this one is right the edge right here, then once you flow it back, it will be perfectly mixed, right? So we're gonna do a little bit change here. We're gonna use the trim command. That's using this big frame and trim off the one over here. So now on the other side, we need to make sure it's perfect align over there. So what we're gonna do is we're going to use the straight line and snapping it to the end point right here. Draw a straight line down and using this line to trim over here. Okay, so now with that little extra, this is my little trick over here. Let's go ahead to use the scale 1D. We're gonna snap in into this point right here. And then the first reference point, that's snapping into the end point right here. Okay, holding your shift and bring it back to this edge. So when they flow it back, there will be 100% contact. So now we have this on one side. We just need to mirror to the other side. So using the middle as a center, and then we have that done. Next video, I'm going to show you how to do the middle part, and then we will flow the whole thing back to the ring. Don't forget to like and comment and share my video so I can reach more people. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.